Hey! Kittens, and welcome back to Let's Play Seven Mysteries on the Last Page. Just load that one. They said something began when the guy set foot to the school. He seemed to know what that was. I should have never come here. I should go after Kiara and get us out of here as soon as possible. Right then. He heard glass breaking. It came from the nearby classroom. He tried to convince himself that his companion's prank that was his companion's prank. Why? To express his fear, maybe? Kiara? Kiara, is that you? Or here I come. Yeah, stop horsing around. I know it's you. Please be you. I'm so tired of this. And he walked on and on with all fears running wild in his head until he saw the wind. Stone? Wait. Help! Someone's beyond the window. I must get Kira now. They did not know if it was out of fear or something else, but he ran like heck as if something. As if something terrible was going to happen. It froze him in fear, but for some reason he continued to descend into the darkness, even though he knew fear had long since taken over. A broken bowl? Everything in this school is freaking ancient. These stairs. When I first transferred here, he and I counted the steps for fun. 12 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13. Then something strange happened, but that was far from the strangest. Impossible. Weren't there only 12 steps? He ignored that and continued to observe. The moment he got down the 13th step, the light's back on. Phew. Probably just a generator. Kira must be long gone by now. I should go home too, so before something else happens. Kira! What's that? Nobody knew what was happening then, but everyone felt the need to escape as soon as possible. Even me. The school was always somehow felt sinister and suffocating. Sometimes it was disturbingly silent. The tales floating around only made things worse. I know I should have moved elsewhere. However, things were not so simple. Cannot really describe it. It just felt so close to me. No, it's not nostalgia or familiarity. It's so weird how, after all this, I still don't get that feeling. Weren't they all that could have happened? Ugh, I always zone out when I recall that feeling. But you will know what's happening to me soon enough. Chapter 2. The Music Room. Sometime later, those students started telling a news story. As if trying to have rumours was a school tradition. This story is about a girl who was on the school grounds one night. They said something was there in the music room. Something that was waiting for the girl to open the door and step inside. Always such a slowpoke. I will leave him behind. She was just outside the music room when she heard. She knew something was wrong, but she could not keep her curiosity in check. Then she slipped inside, dumb just like many people. So dark. The lights won't turn on. Silence covered the room. She knew something was wrong and decided to leave. But right when she got to the door, slammed shut on her. Just seconds later, the eerie dead silence returned. The music room was somewhat noisy and lively during the day, but no one can picture it when night falls. Absolutely no. A minute later, the room turned into a sea of blood. She shrieked out, "It has begun. I must get him in bed as soon as possible." She tried to break the door open, but all efforts seemed futile. And then she screamed, as if there was someone at school to hear her scream. But all just forgot her. She then realized that there was nothing she could do. Suddenly she remembered what made her enter the darkness. She slowly made her way to the piano. Nothing. She felt hopeless. Trying to get out, but she didn't know what to do. She thought things over, then tried to open that door again. Huh? A notebook. It fell from above. The light's back on. As I thought, there's a huge hole in the ceiling, and the book must have fallen from there. This looks like my escape route, but that's way too high. I need someone to help me reach it. A candle. Table's too low, I can never reach over with this. It's not high enough to reach it. let's see where he's at. Move. I am confused. Ah, wait, I can stack the four tables and then climb the four chairs to climb up. How can I only afford this now? Alright, this time. I know it's two Dharma cards. Well, saved and we've made some good progress here. This is the end of this part. I'll see you, kittens, next time.